Dozens of Muslims in Gaza attend Eid prayers outside a ruined mosque in Rafah City. Worshippers knelt in a street next to the wrecked Al-Farouq Mosque with their prayer mats laid out in the shadows of the flattened building. Over a million Palestinians are crammed into Rafah, the last relatively safe place for civilians in the besieged enclave. Muslims in the Philippines marking the end of the Feast of Ramadan, or the holy month of fasting, as they observe Eid al-Fitr. Thousands flock to the Golden Mosque in Quiapo to mark this religious event. Over in Davao City, hundreds attended the Eid al-Fitr congressional prayer. President Marcos called on Muslims in the country to embody humility, peace, and strength. He also calls for unity, despite what he calls diversity in beliefs and philosophies among Filipinos.
Credit rating agency Fitch slashes its outlook on China's sovereign credit rating to negative as its economy faces growing uncertainty. Fitch says its outlook revision reflects challenges in Beijing's public finance as it grapples with decelerating growth and growing debt. The credit rating agency adds it's possible to see credit polarization in China's local financing vehicles as its provincial governments see weaker fiscal health. Fitch, however, maintained China's issuer default rating at A+. The outlook cut follows a similar move by Moody's in December as Beijing ramps up efforts to spur a feeble post-COVID recovery through fiscal and monetary support. President Marcos expresses horror at the idea that Philippine sovereignty was compromised over an alleged secret deal struck by his predecessor with China. The erstwhile spokesperson of former President Rodrigo Duterte alleged that he agreed on a compromise deal with Chinese leader Xi Jinping on the West Philippine Sea issue. Harry Roque claimed the deal barred Manila from fortifying its lone outpost in Ayungin Shoal. Marcos says he will seek clarity on the agreement from former administration officials.
It turns out we don't know. It is a secret agreement. We don't know anything about it. There is no documentation. There is no record. There is no... We were not briefed when I came into office. Walang nagsabi sa amin na merong ganung usapan. So we're trying to really, up to now, because from the former administration, iba-iba ang sagot eh. Sabi ng isang official, dating government official under the previous administration, there's no such agreement. Sabi naman ng isa, no, there is and we should honor it. Sabi naman ng iba, maganda yan. Sabi ng iba, hindi maganda yan. Hindi pa namin alam kung ano ba talaga yung agreement na yan. Kung ang sinasabi sa agreement na yan na kailangan tayong magpermiso sa ibang bansa para gumalaw sa ating sariling teritoryo, mahirap siguro sundan yung ganyang klaseng agreement. I am horrified by the idea that we have compromised through a secret agreement the territory, the sovereignty, and the sovereign rights of the Philippines.
Duterte's former lawyer Salvador Banelo reiterated Wednesday their denial on the existence of the deal. Panelo insisted no such agreement was made and suggested Marcos may have been misled into believing it.